So good morning, everyone.
In the yesterday lecture, we saw this equation, which is known as thermodynamic absolute thermodynamics temperature. Okay, and this equation is proposed by Kelvin. Okay, and it's defined like this: means whatever the heat interaction Q1 upon Q2 is equal to T1 upon T2. Means we can write Q1 upon T1 respect to temperature is equal to Q2 upon T2, right? So these temperatures are respect to temperature. Whatever the temperature reservoirs, the heat is given to the system or given by the system, okay? And their respective temperatures are being taken here. Okay, so if you consider this is an one engine, if we consider, then the T is whatever the temperature we are taking for the Q is related to that reservoir temperature. Okay, and for the Q2, for the triple point of the water, we take triple point temperature. Okay, so this definition by the Kelvin, which is absolute thermodynamics temperature definition, is very useful to define a new property known as entropy. Okay, we saw that the two reversible adiabatic or two reversible adiabatic processes does not meet to each other. Okay, those are parallel to each other on the PV and TS plot. Okay, that we see. And again we saw the Clausius theorem. What is mean by Clausius theorem? Okay, what is the Clausius theorem? A reversible line can be replaced by the two reversible adiabatic line and one reversible isothermal line. If we consider there is one reversible process which in which the particular system goes from state I to the state F, initial state to the final state, through this one reversible process, okay, any reversible process, then we can replace this reversible process by two reversible adiabatic processes and one reversible isothermal process. Okay, so we can replace this by this second reversible isothermal and reversible adiabatic, these two reversible adiabatic. And what we consider or what we assume that the area below this original reversible process is the same or equal to the area below these two second path, okay, which is having the two reversible adiabatic processes and one reversible isothermal process. That means the work remain constant, whatever the work interaction will be constant in the both processes. So on the basis of that, here we assume that the work transfer will be same. So whenever we apply the first law of thermodynamics, as we know, these two are states of the system. That means the internal energy difference in internal energy will be remain same. Okay, so whenever we consider or equal this to the this, the or we can what you can we can minus equation 1 from the equation 2, then we can this, as we know, the work is remain constant, it will be cancelled, as well as the internal, whatever the difference between internal energy of the system is the same, because you whatever the internal energy, this is the property of a system. Okay, so this will be the same, so it will cancel out, and we get QF, whatever the heat transfer in the first reversible process, is equal to the heat transfer during this second path, which is having two reversible adiabatics and one reversible isothermal process. Now for the adiabatics, as we know, the heat transfer will be zero, right? That is the definition of adiabatic process. For any adiabatic process, heat transfer will be zero. That means the QIA and QBF will be zero. and that's why the QIF is equal to the QAB. Okay, so whatever the heat transfer for the first reversible path or reversible process is equal to the heat transfer during this isothermal line, reversible isothermal process. Okay, so we are going to use that concept into the second one, the main Clausius theorem. Okay, here what happened, we take one PV plot, on that we take one reversible cycle. Okay, it may have any two processes. Okay, from here to the from this point to the this point. Okay, we consider this is one reversible cycle. This is the X starting and this is the Y. Okay, so we consider this one reversible cycle. Okay, one note point that it is a reversible cycle. Now what we do, we divide that cycle. Okay, we divide that cycle with the Carnot cycles. Okay, so for that what we do, we draw some isotherms, some reversible adiabatics which should be parallel to each other, right? Whenever we draw the reversible adiabatic lines, those lines will be parallel to each other, they cannot cross each other, right? Similarly, we also draw reversible isotherms. Okay, reversible isothermal processes, though these are the reversible isothermal processes. Okay, and we draw like that the area under this circular reversible cycle is equal to the area which under this divided cycle. Okay, so what we do actually, that we just divide this circular cycle into the many cycles, or this cycle, you can see the steps, right? So we just divide into this type of cycles, right? Again this, then again this circular, like this. So we just divided into, likewise as we divided these reversible process into their different path, right, having same work interaction, like that we divided this circular reversible process or reversible cycle into the many numbers of reversible adiabatics and reversible isothermal processes, considering the whatever the work interaction will remain same. Okay, in the circular reversible cycle and also in this modified reversible cycle, the work remains same. Again, after that what we do, we divide that modified reversible cycle into the many Carnot cycle or many cycles. Okay, and any Carnot cycle, what it contains, it contains two reversible adiabatics and two reversible isothermal processes, right? So here you can see, just a second, so here you can see this, if you consider one Carnot cycle, this is one Carnot cycle, just a second. Okay, so this is one Carnot cycle. Likewise, the second one is this. Okay, so like that we divide this original reversible cycle to many reversible adiabatics and reversible isotherm, and as we contain two reversible adiabatics and two reversible isotherms, it is called as Carnot cycle, because Carnot cycle also having two reversible adiabatic processes and two reversible isothermal processes. This is as we already seen. Okay, so now we have to thermodynamically analyze that one particular cycle. Okay, now we consider one cycle A, B, C, D. This is A, B, C, D. Okay, it will absorb some heat okay, it will absorb some heat dq1 and reject some heat, okay, which is taken as dq2. Okay, now those all the processes are reversible processes. Okay, whatever the processes or whatever the cycles we are going to see in the entropy definition are the reversible cycles, because those are very easy or simple to analyze. Okay, that's why we considering only a reversible adiabatic processes or reversible isothermal processes or any reversible circle or any reversible cycle. Okay, so as we know this, if we consider this first small elemental cycle, which is ABCD, which is take some heat dq1 from the temperature T1, the temperature of this is T1, and reject the heat reversibly at temperature T2. Okay, so by using that temperature, absolute thermodynamics temperature scale, what we can write, we can write down dq1, whatever the temperature inlet, upon dq2. Okay, we use d because it is, that is elemental, okay, very small amount of heat. Okay, that's why we write differentiate d, okay, is equal to t1 upon t2. Okay, so using that thermodynamic, absolute thermodynamics temperature scale, we can write down this, because this is reversible cycle. Okay, so it follow the rule that absolute thermodynamics temperature scale only applicable to the reversible cycle, and this is the reversible cycle. That's why we can write down dq1 upon dq2 is equal to t1 upon t2. Okay, now we take this t1 on the left side and this dq2 on the right side. So we can follow, or we can get this equation, dq1 upon t1 is equal to dq2 upon t2. Okay, now what we consider, or we know that for any system, okay, this is if this is a system, any system, if heat is received by the system, this heat is taken as a positive, right, positive heat. Okay, and whatever the heat rejected by the system, we consider as a negative heat, right? So we just put up that sign conventional to this. So we can write this as a, this dq1 is heat addition, whatever the heat is received by the system, that means it will be the positive. So we write down as dq1 plus dq1 upon t1 is equal to this dq2, whatever the heat rejected by the system, we taken as a negative system, that means it will be the minus dq2 upon t2. Okay, we can write down this equation or transform into this equation. After that, we take this minus dq2 upon t2 on the left hand side, that's why it takes plus. Okay, that's why it is plus. So what we get, the equation dq1 upon t1 plus dq2 upon t2 is equal to 0. Okay, this is equation first for the first cycle. Now if we consider, if you consider the second cycle, okay, if you consider second cycle is what, the EF, then it is up to GH and again to V. So this second cycle, if you consider second elemental cycle, second small cycle, because the we divide that original cycle into the many small cycles, okay, which is contain reversible adiabatics and reversible isothermal processes. So similarly for the second cycle, we can write down the dq3 is a heat absorption, okay, and the dq4 is a heat rejection. So similarly for the second cycle, we can write down like this, dq3 upon t3 plus dq4 upon t4, where dq3 is heat absorption and dq4 it is rejection. That means by using this sign conventional, we can write down this and we get the second equation. So if we apply this concept, okay, this same concept, similar concept, the other cycles which are available, small cycles. Okay, whenever we apply this concept to the other small cycles, all these small cycles, okay, what we can write down? Okay, we can write down dq1 upon t1 plus dq2 upon t2 plus dq3 upon t3 plus dq4 upon t4 plus as so on is equal to 0, because right hand side is a 0. That means whenever we add this all the heat transfer upon d over t1, it becomes 0. Okay, so for this equation we can write down one expression, that cyclic integration whenever for the reversible cycle, this is r, dq upon t is equal to 0. So for a cyclic reversible process, the dq upon t will be 0. The integration, whatever the integration we consider, this is means whenever we add the all the heat transfer upon the temperature. Okay, this for the addition we write down the integration, and it is cyclic integration. That means there whatever the process it is carried out here is a cyclic process. Okay, its initial and final state is similar. Okay, so we got this equation, and this is known as Clausius theorem. Okay, this equation is known as Clausius theorem. Okay, so this is very important. This is known as Clausius theorem, and it is only applicable for reversible cycle. This R is given, reversible cycle. Okay, this is not a any process, only any single process. It is complete thermodynamic cycle plus it is reversible cycle. Okay, that's for that only, whatever the heat transfer upon the temperature is equal to 0, and this temperature is a reservoir temperature, not a system temperature. Okay, so this is called as Clausius theorem. Okay, so based on that we can define the entropy of a system. Okay, so as we know from consider there is another system. Okay, there is another plot, PV plot. Okay, and it have two reversible processes. First one is a R1 process, which is go from initial to final I to F state. Okay, and again there is another process, another reversible process known as R2. Okay, it is goes from F state F to the state I. Okay, so both are the reversible process, that's why we call it is R1 and R2. Okay, so by using Clausius theorem, what we can write down? We can write whatever the cyclic integration of the processes R1 and R2, reversible processes R1, R2, which is consist one cycle, dq upon t is equal to 0. So by using this Clausius theorem, which is applied to this system, we can write down whatever the cyclic integration for the reversible cycle, dq upon t is equal to 0. Okay, now the above integral may be replaced as a sum of two integrals. Okay, this integral may be replaced or can be replaced by using two integral. Okay, so each for each path there will be one integration, right? So for that we write down first integration for the first reversible path, okay, R1 from I to F dq upon t plus integration F to I for the R2 path, dq upon t is equal to 0, because this is 0, cyclic integration is a 0. Now what we do, we put or move this term to the on the right side. As we move this term on the right side, we get negative sign. Okay, this positive become negative. Okay, now what we get, integration from I to F for the R1 process, R1 dq upon t is equal to integration from F to I for the reversible process R2 dq upon t minus, this is minus 1. Okay, now what we do, we merge that minus sign into this integration. And as a law, as you know, laws of integration, when we merge this minus, the states or the whatever the limits are interchanged. Okay, so both are the reversible processes, reversible paths. So when we merge this into the limits, limits are interchanged, and as this R2 is reversible path, then we can interchange the limits, because this process is applicable, or we can move in any direction because this is a reversible process, right? So that's why the as a minus sign is merged, we interchange the whatever the limits of that integration. Okay, so what we get, integration I to F R1 dq upon t is equal to integration I to F R2 dq upon t. So from this, what we get, the for that particular path, okay, for that particular path, whatever the heat interaction during the path R1 and during the path R2, and its ratio to the temperature of that reservoir or the, during that heat transfer is equal. That means whatever the integration of the any reversible cycle I to F dq upon T is given by Sf minus Sd. So this one should be one property. Okay, so the, what mean that means, whatever the whenever we find out these terms dq upon T, okay, for any reversible cycle, okay, this is the any reversible cycle, when we find out the term dq upon T, it is only whatever, it is only based on the final states, okay, initial and final state, what are the end state of the processes. Okay, so for any, why so the that is what do we call it as derived from the Clausius theorem, we use this Clausius theorem, and using this we can find out whatever the heat transfer happened during R1 and whatever the heat transfer happened during R2, that heat transfer upon the temperature, these terms remain constant. Okay, and whenever the term remain constant, that means for any reversible cycle, whenever the terms, any term remain constant, is that the property of a system, that term will be the property of a system. Because if you consider pressure P1, okay, pressure P1 at a initial state, what is the definition of engineering thermodynamic cycle? Thermodynamic cycle is a series of processes where initial state and the final state remain same, right? So here what happened, when this system passed through the R1 and comes back through the R2, it's come to its initial state, and the so the at the finally after completion of the cycle, the pressure will remain P1, right? Because it comes to its original state. Likewise, whatever the heat interaction taken in the first reversible process, and whatever the heat interaction takes in the second reversible process, those heat interactions are the same. Okay, also the dq upon T, whatever these terms, is the same for the both processes. That means whenever we move this process on the left hand side, the their addition will be zero, because it's become minus, and this my plus and this minus cancels. That means the change in the process, change in the property, this property dq upon T will zero, right? So change in this dq upon T will be zero. So we can get this change in that particular equation or particular expression is zero only if this is the property of a system. जेव्हा ही जी एक्सप्रेशन आहे dq upon T, त्यामध्ये चेंज झिरो कधी असणार आहे? फॉर द थर्मोडायनॅमिक सायकल, जेव्हा ही जो एक्सप्रेशन आहे ती सिस्टीमची प्रॉपर्टी असायला पाहिजे, अँड धीस प्रॉपर्टी इज नोन ॲज एन्ट्रॉपी. Okay, so this dq upon T is known as entropy of a system. Okay, and we can only express in this for the reversible cycle. Okay, reversible thermodynamic cycle only. So this is the state of a system, which is means this entropy is depends on the whatever the state of a system is, does not depend on the path of a system. Okay, it does not depend path of a system, but first assumption is that whatever the process takes place, it should be the reversible process. If you want to find out entropy change, that path should be a reversible process. We cannot find out entropy change for irreversible processes. Okay, so for the any reversible process from I to F, dq upon T is known as change in entropy. Okay, so if we consider there is only one process, R1 process will be there, then to find out change in the process, change in the entropy, because entropy is a property of a system, that means this state contains some entropy and this state also contains some entropy. This is SI, this is SF. So whenever one reversible process will takes place, at that time the difference between the property entropy is given by integration of I to F dq upon T, and this path must be reversible. Okay, so by using this formula we can define or we can find out the entropy difference between the two state of a system. Okay, so whenever these two equilibrium states are infinitely small or near, okay, so whatever the change between those states are very small, very very small, then we can write down dqr upon T is equal to ds, where dqr, r is for reversible process, whatever the heat transfer taken in reversible process, upon temperature of surrounding, this is the temperature of a surrounding, is equal to ds. This is exact differential. Okay, and as we know, this property entropy is a property of a system, that means it is point function. Okay, it does not depend on the whatever the paths. Okay, it is little confusing property, right? Again, we can define entropy as a amount of heat contained in a substance and the degree to which it is ordered, means whatever the heat present in the system and how much in which order that heat is ordered, it is present in the system, that order is known as entropy of a system. Means what? If some system having some heat, okay, and it is in a very good order, okay, this is not in a disorder, okay, which is in a very very good order, okay, that means it have a less entropy. Okay, it is having a less entropy. When disorder is increased, okay, so if we consider this another system which is having very disordered heat, then the entropy of that system will increase. Entropy of this system is more. Okay, so entropy is, if we consider, entropy is directly proportional to disorder. Okay, disorder of the heat energy, disorder of a heat energy, disorder of a heat energy. Okay, and as we know, work is a high grade energy, right? And it is in the mostly in an ordered state. That means entropy does not depend on work interaction, it is only depend on heat interaction. Okay, so whenever we considering any path, the entropy will be calculated only if there will be heat interaction. When there will be no heat interaction, no entropy change will be there. Okay, one example is, whenever we consider any isentropic or reversible adiabatic process. In that, what happen if we plot that reversible adiabatic process on the TS graph? It is a vertical line. Means what? This is the initial and this is the final stage. That means what? Whatever the temperature will change, but there will be no heat interaction in the reversible adiabatic process, right? That's why entropy remain constant, delta S remain constant, delta S is equal to zero, right? That's why we plot the isentropic process as a vertical line on a TS graph. So in Carnot cycle or in a Carnot cycle, we already seen that there are two isothermal and two isentropic processes are there. So for the Carnot cycle, we write down like as a square, because these two processes are isothermal processes, means temperature remain constant, and these two processes are isentropic process, means entropy remain constant. Okay, and most important that entropy generation or entropy change is only applicable or only related to the heat transfer. Okay, whenever there is a heat transfer, there is a change in entropy. Okay, if there is only work transfer, then entropy remain constant. If there is only work transfer and no heat transfer, at that time entropy remain constant. So entropy is only happen if there is a heat interaction. Okay, if there is no heat interaction, no heat, no entropy change will be happen. Okay, so this is the property of a system. Entropy is a property of a system. Okay, so for any reversible process, reversible cycle, we can calculate entropy by using this formula, which is given as integration R I to F, initial state to final state, dq upon T. This is change in the entropy. We can find out entropy change using this formula. Okay, and this entropy is a extensive property. Okay, this entropy is a extensive property, means it is depend on the mass. So if you want to find out intensive entropy, that is means known as specific entropy, which is given by total entropy upon mass, and their unit is joule per kg Kelvin. Okay, for the specific entropy. For regular entropy, for this entropy, unit is joule per Kelvin. Okay, whenever we divide by mass, we take as take units kg, joule per kg Kelvin, which is for specific entropy. Okay, so this is the entropy. Entropy means how much heat, in which manner heat is present in that particular system, in an order manner or a disorder manner. If disorder of that heat in the system is goes up, the entropy also increases. Okay, so this is the entropy, which is a property of a system. Okay, so we will stop here. It is very confusing, property of a system. Okay, so it will take time for you to understand what is meant by entropy. If you have any doubt, you can ask in the chat box, or you can unmute yourself and ask, because this is very important and very confusing property. Okay, it is only related to heat transfer only. Okay, it is not related to work transfer. Whenever there is some heat interaction, then there will be some entropy change. Okay, if there is no heat interaction, then entropy change also not there. Okay, so for adiabatic, reversible adiabatic process, what we can what we know, the heat transfer will be zero. That's why change in the entropy will be zero for that particular reversible adiabatic or isentropic process. Okay, and this change in the entropy will given by this formula, which is integration of reversible cycle I to F dq upon T is equal to Sf minus Si. Okay. So this is the basic, or what is the property of entropy, is a property of a system. Okay, if you have any doubts, you can ask. We will see this on the next lecture, how to find out entropy for irreversible process. Okay, because all the natural processes are irreversible processes. So whenever we have to find out entropy change for that irreversible process, what we do, we will see in the next lecture. Okay, and after that we will going to see Clausius inequality. So if you have any doubts regarding what is entropy, what is Clausius theorem, so whenever we go for Clausius theorem, this expression you will find out. Okay, cyclic integration of reversible process or reversible cycle, dq upon t will always be zero. This is very important to define entropy. Okay, so these are the Clausius theorem, and based on that we defined entropy, one property of a system which is known as entropy. Okay, and we can find out entropy of any reversible cycle using this equation. Okay, and for the find out specific entropy, we divide that total entropy by mass of the system. Okay, so if you have any doubts, you can put that doubts in the chat box. If you have doubts any, please put this in chat box. Don't worry, I will share this recorded videos of these lectures on YouTube. Okay, so you can revise them afterward. Sign convention of what? Theta, Q. Okay, so sign convention of which one? As we know, the entropy is depend on heat interaction. Okay, so whatever the sign conventional for the heat interaction related, that entropy will change. Okay, means what? If we add the heat, what will happen? If we add the heat, this term will be positive. Okay, if you add the heat, this term will be positive. That means change in entropy is positive, means entropy will increase. Okay, for the particular system. Okay, and if this heat is given by the system, that means what? This term will be taken as negative, because we reduce the heat, it is lost by the system. So the change in entropy of that particular system is negative. Okay, we will see that. So whatever the sign conventional for the Q related, that entropy will increase or decrease. Okay, so you must know the sign conventional of heat transfer. Whatever the, whenever we give heat, or whatever when heat is absorbed by the system, that means heat is added to the system, that means we take heat as a positive. And whenever heat given by the system or heat rejected by the system, then we take it as a negative. Okay, so based on this, whatever the sign convention of entropy will take place. Okay, it is totally based on heat. Okay, it does not based on work. Okay, so work cha kahi sambandh nahi hai entropy calculation madhe. We only find whatever the heat interaction, and entropy is only, whatever the change in the entropy is only because of heat interaction only. Okay, there, whenever there is one system, if you have that particular system have work interaction, then there will be no change in entropy. But if it is contain some or any form of heat interaction, then there will be change in entropy. Okay, so sign conventional is totally depend on sign conventional of the heat. Okay, so we will see in the examples also. Okay, so you will be clear. So if anyone have a doubts, just put it in chat box. If everyone is clear, then type yes, no. So shall we stop here? Shall we stop here? Type yes, no for the participants. Okay, so we will stop here.